Hey, Midnight Science Club. We have a new series coming. It's called Maker Science, and it's hosted by one of our dear friends, Tamara Robertson. We're gonna have an interview with her today, and we're actually gonna get to see a clip. So stick around for that after the interview. But right now, I wanna introduce you to Tamara Robertson. Are you there, Tamara?
I'm here.
There she is. How you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Well, I'm still old, but I'm still handsome. Still have the beard and everything. Yeah, we're doing all right. Where's the surfboard?
It's in the garage. It's resting for the cold month.
What else in your background can you share with us?
I tend to say that I'm a collector of skills. So
yes.
Most things that I come across in life, I try at least once. And when I like them, they stick around. But as far as my background, I'm a chemical and biomolecular engineer.
Ooh.
I've spent a good deal amount of time, I'm not going to say how long nowadays, in that career, doing everything from designing and building vaccines facilities to helping Fortune 500 companies design products and launch them. But most people that see my face and recognize it, it's because I've spent a great deal of time on their televisions in their living rooms working with the Mythbusters franchise, as well as a fun prank show called Sidejinks.
Really? You were on that too? Man, this is incredible. A biochemical, biomolecular engineer, a chemist, a surfer, and you're a consultant and you work on television. And on top of that, I saw you're a maker. Now tell me what a maker is.
We're all makers. We use tools, we are creative, we're curious, we kind of take things and try to figure out how to make them into new things or how to combine them to make something better. So a maker can be anyone from someone that bakes bread to someone that quenches steel, someone that's building your chairs to someone that's embroidering a nice blanket. So what I love about it is it's all encompassing. It's really whatever skill you want to play with that day, which again, as an avid skill collector, is probably one of my favorite parts about the maker movement.
It sounds like you're all over the place. I'm telling you, this is incredible. Does it ever end? Well, let's narrow it down a bit. Do you have a favorite build that you've done?
So one of my favorite builds outside of engineering, exploding and making art as a combined effort, is probably still one of the coolest things as an engineer to get to do. So my favorite build is what we called the Dandelion of Doom. And it was a over 1 ton steel dandelion that we put 36 basic shotgun nozzles on, filled the nozzles with paint, dropped a pound of C4 into, and made an effort to paint a room. The room may have had less walls when we were done with it. It was just a really cool collaborative project.
She lost me at exploding art. When she said exploding art, my mind went off. You know, I said, oh, I like this. I like this girl. And did you hear the magic words, C4? Oh, my heart started to pound when she said, a pound of C4 and paint. My, she's crazy, just like the rest of us. This is beautiful. You know, Midnight Science Club, we've got a new series coming, and Tamara's going to tell us all about it.
So our new series is called Maker Science, and it'll come out later this month. What's really fun is that whenever we go and we meet with our experts and our friends that are makers, we let them actually throw their own fireballs. So for episode one, we joined forces with Matter Hackers and the Broken Nerd, and the Matter Hackers team had a little bit too much fun with fire, but you'll see that in the clip.
We get to throw our own fireball. What beautiful words those are. So let's see the clip.
And 3, 2, 1.
They threw their own fireball. Sweet.
It was a lot of fun.
You're carrying on a good wizard tradition there.
Well, if you want to see it early and catch some fun behind the scenes moments, our Patreon is going to have lots of offerings from this new series.
Oh, that's right. You can catch it early on Patreon. What was I thinking? Of course. Tamara, I've got a question from one of our Patreon club members, and they want to know all about Mythbusters Junior. What was one of your favorite parts of working on that?
Whenever I'm working with young makers, I find so inspiring that I'm learning from them as much as they're learning from me. So I went in with the goal of teaching all of them welding before the end of the season, but I also learned a lot about robotics myself from young Valerie. So it was really neat because it was definitely a mentor-mentee trading of knowledge. And I tell older makers all the time that the apprenticeship model has become a circle instead of a one-way street. So it was neat to see that in action.
You don't know something yourself until you try to teach it to somebody else. So you said it, that learning is a cyclical thing. You learn as much as they do. Now I've got another question for you. This project we're gonna do together, why is it important?
I think that it's really important to be highlighting maker skills alongside STEM. You know, there's this stigma that those that work with their hands are not equivalent to those that work with their minds. It's something that I think that this series is going to highlight the intelligence and the craftsmanship that goes into making with your hands, while also linking it back to the really cool science that is there if you want to take the time to deep dive it. So I think we're gonna add that A to STEM and make it STEAM, and we're gonna make sure that everyone gets to, again, throw some fireballs.
Oh, Tamara, you said the magic word, that craftsmanship. You know, it takes quite a while to become a craftsman. You have to use your hands over and over. You have to train your hands to do so many things, and this is such a good example of that. Brains and hands coming together. This is gonna be great. So I've got one more question for you. You've been up to so many different things, surfing and welding and changing the lives of people by teaching them how to throw fireballs. What else are you going to be working on? Or do you have time to do anything else these days?
There's so many balls in the air right now. I'm just trying to keep them all juggling. But some exciting things that are coming out. We just released my outreach comic, Seekers of Science, in Spanish. And I've actually just launched a new podcast called Tinkering Bells, where I am highlighting and interviewing amazing female makers from all over the globe and getting to share their builds as well as their stories.
Was that all?
That's all.
That's all you're up to? What, you got about 3 minutes left every day to surf?
You know, I wake up very, very early and I surf with the sunrise, and the water's so cold, I get about 30 minutes and then I'm frozen. So
that's what it is. Well, she surfs for 30 minutes every day in freezing water. What else can I say? I can't top that. Tamara, I'm so glad that you're a member of Midnight Science Club. You're one of our cherished members. I think we're going to have to get a special hat for her.
I'll wear it.
So everybody nod your head and say, hey, Tamara, thanks for joining our club.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah. So Midnight Science Club members, Maker Science, you'll be able to see it later this month. That's going to be fantastic. So I think we'll be seeing a lot of Tamara, and thanks for being with us.